guys. Let me get the baby in focus. Here we go. I'm here with Teandra. I know you guys have not seen her in a Mississippi minute. So I decided that she needs to be in a video. And I need to make a video. And we just need to do this. So I was tagged by Jenny of Springtime Creations Nursery to do the love bug tag. So I'm going to be doing that in this video, and I'm also just going to be chatting about nothing in particular, but just whatever comes into my mind, I'm going to chat about it. So I'm going to change Teandra. I know you haven't seen her in a long time. She's still here. She's still cute. And I'm sure that she's probably blurry because the camera's pretty close to her. I did get it to... Oh, man. I need to buy a new tripod. Something. Like, there needs to be some kind of accessory where you can stand your phone up on an unflat surface like a bed and have it stay still and not fall over. That is what I'm looking for. That. But anyway, I got it now, I think. I moved it back a little bit. So, the love bug tag. I'm just gonna get into it while I'm changing her. And first off, let me show you. So, I'm gonna change her. Let me just move her out of the way so I can show you the clothes. So, I'm gonna change her into this onesie, which is adorable and has little, I'm not sure what those are all over it. I feel like they might be apples. They're sort of tactile, I can feel them, and they're sort of round, and I feel like they might be, or maybe they're hearts. I don't know. They're something. something cute. But it's a cute onesie, and it's got the same thing on the other side. It's like all over it. The little design of whatever these are. Apples, hearts, whatever. Whatevers. And then I'm going to put her in, since it's a beautiful sunny day, and I'm into putting my babies in dresses. Essence is in a dress, so I decided I would put her in one too. So I am going to put her in this dress. Got a cute little collar that's all ruffly that goes all around it. This is actually the front. And it's got little baby snaps on the front and a tag on the back. Always like them when they have a tag on the back because it's very obvious which way is backwards. So yeah, I think I might have put Cadence in this once. Or maybe I put Essence in it once. I put one of them in it once, but I think that Essence and Teandra might be able to share. Things might just be a little bit big on her, on Teandra, but we're gonna give it a try. So, yeah, let's do this. So, the love bug tag. I was tagged by Jenny of Jenny Creation, Springtime Creations Nursery. Sorry, I had a Prince moment going on. The artist formerly known as Jenny Creations. And she tagged me to do this love bug tag, which I believe was started by Pauline of Polly's Princess. And the tag is to tag three channels that I like, and then to explain why I like them and why you should subscribe to them. So it's pretty much giving people shout outs, which I am all about that life. So I have been thinking hard about who I wanted to tag, and I just want to start off by saying that I subscribe to a lot of really great channels, and so if I don't tag someone, it does not in any way mean that I don't like their channel or anything like that. it just means that I can only tag three. I mean, technically, there's no rules. You can do whatever you want, but if I want to make it meaningful, sometimes I feel like less is more. And so I want to be able to explain, you know, why I like this particular channel. So I'm going to tag three. Three channels that I really like that I haven't... I'm going to try to pick channels that I haven't seen other people tag yet. And maybe other people have. Obviously, I don't subscribe to every channel that's out there on YouTube. So I don't know if someone else has maybe tagged someone. But these are people that I have not seen tagged in my list of subs. So, the first channel that I would like to tag with the love bug, and again, if I tag you and you don't want to do it for whatever reason, no pressure, it's all in fun. Don't feel like you have to reciprocate or like you have to do it if you don't want to. It's all good. But the first channel that I'm going to tag is Tori from Tori's Reborn Babies. And Tori's Reborn Babies is a channel that I've been subscribed to for a long time. Tori is one of my friends here on YouTube. We don't talk as often as we maybe should. But she is a wonderful person, a wonderful collector. She's someone in the community that I would like to meet in person one day. I just think it would be super fun to meet her, and I'm trying to figure out which way this goes. I don't want to put the onesie on backwards. I think it would be super fun to meet her, and like, we would have a lot of fun. And Tori is legally blind as well, and I swear, she was the first. I've since met other blind reborn mommies, Nicole and Amy and Anna and all my girls, but Tori was the first one that I met, and I remember seeing she did a video once about the challenges that she faces as a legally blind reborn collector. And now she has since started making her own babies, which I think is pretty fabulous. But at the time she was collecting, she wasn't making. And I saw that video and I was just so excited and invigorated by it that I had to comment on it and be like, OMG girl, me too! And after I found that, it just made me really want to be friends with her. You know how you meet people in your life and you're just like, I really want to be friends with this person. Like, this person is just super cool to me, and like, we need to be BFFs forever. Like, that's kind of how I feel about Tori. So yeah, she is just a genuine person. I love her outing videos, and I don't usually like outing videos, but she always goes on these really cool outings to Target and stuff with her grandpa. And her grandpa is like a super cool dude. Like, he will find baby clothes and stuff for her, and like, it's just so cool. So I love Tori's outing videos. I love her just changing videos and her every videos. She's just really cool, really genuine, and definitely someone that I aspire to be like in the community. So everyone needs to go and subscribe to Tori's Reborn Babies. Tori, if you're watching this, you've been bitten with the love bug. I'm going to comment on your most recent video and let you know as well, because that is what you're supposed to do. Wait a minute. Oh, you know what? Wait. This thing is confusing. I'm assuming that the buttons go on the back of the dress because this collar is just too cute to not be on the front. So I might be putting this on backwards. If I am, Hashtag blind reborn chick props. But whatever, it's all good. My baby can wear her dress backwards. She has no shame. So yeah, Tori's reborn babies. Check her out. She's epic. Although, you know what? I think this actually does go on the... I don't know. It's confusing to me because the tag is on the left-hand side, which usually means the... You know what? But collars of things usually go around the back. I have no idea. I think I'm going to put it on with the buttons on the front. Actually, yeah. I think that is the way it's supposed to go. If it is backwards, then oh well. Still gonna be cute. No shame. Man, when I have real kids, they're gonna be walking around all day with their stuff on backwards. No, they really won't. I won't put my kids through that agony. But this is gonna be cute. So anyway, back to the love bug tag. The next person that I would like to tag with the love bug tag is Dottie of Dottie Reborn Mom 7911. That is her channel, Dottie, D-O-T-T-I-E, Reborn Mom 7911. And she is also one of my personal friends in the community. And she has, oh, this is going to be big on Teandra. Absolutely it is. Dottie has some beautiful babies. But what I like most about Dottie's videos is listening to her speak, which probably sounds really creepy, and all of my shout-outs, I hope they don't come across as creepy. Sometimes I feel like I say things and it comes across as creepy and it's not creepy. So, if it comes across weird, you know what, I think this is backwards. I'm gonna put it on the other way. If it comes across weird, rest assured that I didn't mean it to be weird. Because sometimes I feel like I say things that are weird. But anyway, Dottie Reborn Mom 7911. One of my favorite things about her is listening to her speak because her voice is, she's from Alabama and she has like the cutest southern accent. And I swear, I just wanna like sit on her back porch with her and drink sweet tea and rock our babies. Like, yes girl. So, yeah. She is awesome. She has beautiful babies. Her babies, Addie and Savannah. And I think she has another baby, Ava. Ava, is Ava your baby? Don't hate. I haven't been watching videos in a while. Ava, I believe. But yes, she is, again, just a really cool, genuine person in the community. She is really fun. She makes really cool videos with her babies. And her voice, her speaking voice, is just epic. Oh my gosh, this is huge on her. So yeah, definitely check out Dottie's channel. Because she is cool. And the third person I would like to tag is my girl Erica from Erica Jones. And Erica is another channel that I've been subscribed to for a long time. Ugh, you know what? This is backwards. It has to be because the tag never goes at the front. Okay, third time. I'm gonna flip it around. Oh my god, I can't even right now. I can't even believe I'm gonna post this video. This poor baby, she's like, oh my god, are you serious? Yep. We're live, guys. What you see is truly what you get. But Yes, Erica Jones is a wonderful lady in our community. She has beautiful silicones. She has, I think, 2 Claire Taylor silicones and some other silicones. I think she has a Reborn as well. But she's just another person. Like, all the people that I've tagged in this tag are people that I feel are really passionate about the hobby. And, like, you can just tell that they love their babies and that it's more than just a collection. That, you know, these dolls are truly a big part of these people's lives. And Erica Jones is definitely somebody who I feel that way about. You can just tell when she makes her videos. She is in it, you know, for the long haul. She loves her babies. And she does videos on caring for silicones. And she does changing videos and all kind of good stuff. So yeah, definitely check out Miss Erica Jones. And those are my 3 for the Love Bug tag. So y'all, I'm gonna comment on your most recent videos and just let you know that I've tagged you, just in case you don't watch this. And yeah, I hope everybody goes and subscribes to these 3 wonderful ladies. Tori's Reborn Babies, Dottie Reborn Mom 7911, and Erica Jones, because they are really awesome and valuable members of our community, and they're genuine and they're kind, and they are just a pleasure to watch. So yeah, oh my goodness, child, this dress is way too big on her. I definitely must have put this on Essence, because it's just not fitting. This is definitely Essence's, and this little girl is smaller, not gonna fit. Well, it is. It's just gonna be big. Is there only one button? Weird. Okay, well, she's not gonna be in it for long, I will tell you that. I will be changing her out of this soon, because it's huge on her. But anyway, here she is. Here's your little girl, little baby. And yeah, I think I know what I want to change her into, and it's something that I change her into a lot. But for now, I'm going to keep her in this, because it is big, but it's cute. So, I'm thinking that this baby right here, little Miss Teandra Brianne, is probably going to be the baby that I take with me to Rose. I was gonna take Irie, but I feel like there's gonna be a lot of Saskias there, and I kind of want to be unique, and I feel like Teandra is the Mickey sculpt by Marita Winters, and she was reborn by Yogi of Yolanda Boy Glover. Yogi babies, I bought her from Mia's Dolls and Fun. And she is beautiful. I think she's pretty exquisite. I can't believe that I got her for the price that I did. And I'm just in love with this baby. So I really think that to be a little bit more unique, I'm gonna bring her with me, I think, to Rose. Now, it is a ways away, so I could change my mind 50 times between now and then. To be honest, the thought of not having Essence with me for a good 3 or 4 days or whatever kind of sucks. So I really wish I could bring both of them, but I don't know how traveling with 2 babies would really work, especially since I don't have an official doll bag. I got, last year when I went to the doll show in North Carolina, I just packed Essence in a duffel bag and I put a blanket around her, like fully, including her face, just like wrapped her all the way up in a soft blanket. And she was fine, but I don't know that I could fit two babies in that same duffel bag. So I don't really, I mean, I did when I brought Ashton home. I put them both in there and wrapped them both up. But Ashton is a little bit teeny tiny preemie, so he fit just fine. But I don't know how easy it would be to pack two larger full-term babies in the duffel bag. So I don't know that I'm going to be able to bring two, but I'm thinking that if I don't bring two, then Teandra is probably going to be it, because she is unique, and she's a yogi baby. Like, why would I not want to show that off, you know? So, yeah, I have a feeling as of this moment, as of this video, she will be the one that I'll be bringing. But like I said, I could change my mind 50 times between now and then. But I have had a lot of urge to snuggle with Teandra lately, and I've been feeling separation anxiety from her when I've been at work. So, yeah. But anyway, I guess I'm gonna end this video for now. I hope you've all enjoyed watching the love bug tag, and I hope you can see a little bit.